Hello, my dear students at home. Happy to meet you again online. My name is Ojo Thomas, social studies teacher. In fact, I meet you all, and I know that very soon we are going to see how we break the yoke of this pandemic and what has built the wall of incompatibility for not seeing each other. So, for this, my name is Ojo Thomas, and this afternoon we are going to talk about social studies and a certain topic that is very interesting in our social studies. That is, the topic therein is roles of science and technology in modern society in this our age, not in traditional society. Not in that civilized society, this is a civilized society, this is our age. Then, this video is meant for JSS2 students for week 6. I want you all to take your daughter, your pen, and listen attentively to this video as I will be touching some vital points in science and technology. But what I want you to know. My aim, my specific objective concerning this topic is that at the end of the lesson, students will be able to, one, understand the rules of science and technology in Nigeria, two, state the problem created by science and technology. So, all the problems created by science and technology, and the role that science and technology play in this our modern age. The roles and the importance of science and technology. When I'm talking about the roles, the impact that it plays, in our modern society. Science and technology have helped to improve the quality of man in the following way. It improved the quality of man in this way. Let's name them. It has improved in agricultural system. It means it has improved in agriculture. This is through the production of modern implements, such as tractor, planter, sprayer, chemical, like insecticides, herbicides, and many more. In those days, our forefathers used what? They used manual tools. They used traditional tools. Tools are different for implement or machineries that they use on farm. See, before, nothing like tractor, nothing like planter, nothing like sprayer, nothing like chemical like fertilizer. Fertilizer is a chemical that enables our plant, our crops to grow very well. Nothing like insecticide that kills or eliminates all the pests in the farm. Before, our forefathers used barn, they call it barn. They just put their crops, like corn or yams, in the barn to keep them in the barn, whereby the rodents will go there and then eat up, or any kind of animals. But in this modern life, we have stores where we can keep them. There are some chemicals that we can spray on these crops, so that the rodents will not be able to eat them. This is our modern age. It's different from the traditional age. Tractor works on farm to cultivate, to make fields, ridges, instead of using manual hoe to make heaps. See the impact of science and technology in agriculture. What about the poultry production of eggs? It's part of it. Production of eggs, livestock, rearing of animals like pigs, poultry. It has improved in the areas of the agricultural system. Secondly, it has improved healthcare delivery. Can you imagine? Healthcare delivery. So societies have developed through science and technology. For example, the establishment of social amenities and infrastructures like hospitals, like maternity, like clinic. That is where people go for their treatments when they are sick, or where the pregnant women go to for their treatments. It has improved healthcare delivery. Thirdly, it has improved the communication system through service and technology. Communication system through science and technology. It's that science and technology that enable us to talk, to make rapport, to communicate with those people in the foreign countries. Maybe not because of your handsets, Android, all the kinds of computer, either laptop or desktop or whatever, that enable us before, because our parents, our forefathers not doing these videos. It's the work of science and technology. It has improved in the area of communication system. I can be able to talk to people in abroad, in Canada, in the US. Before, those are our forefathers. We are not opportune to talk to those people unless they use their traditional, they talk to them in their traditional way. Don't let us go to that. Number four, it has also improved our transportational system. Our transportational system through cars, through ferry, through ship, through boats, flyboats, steamers. Oh God, see, science and technology. People in medical aspect of it, we know they know how they can use herbs, leaves of plants to produce tablets, to produce drugs, to make injections like chloroquine or this paracetamol. They use plants to make all the things that they can improve the infection of science and technology. According to the Pope says, necessity is the mother of infection. See, we are now improving daily in all the ramifications of other educational processes, other agricultural processes, other communicational processes, other transformational processes, or a lot more. See the work, the impact of science and technology. Go with place. It has some problems. Some problems created by science and technology. One, pollution of environment. Smoke from the industrial smoke, from vehicles and motorcycles, pollute the air. See, if you are going along the street, you'll be hearing from the factory, from their engines. It's through the help of science and technology that they brought this thing to Nigeria and it's giving us another bad aspect of it. In fact, nobody can inhale this thing, the smoke, into the nose. And the person will be alright. Secondly, accidents. The product of science and technology, such as motor vehicle, aeroplanes, cause accidents. People like ship, because accidents daily. You know, last week that I heard about an accident that happened along the Lagos-Ibadan expressway, the tanker that exploded. And thus, many things happened. Life lost, your properties damaged, and got burnt. If not because of this science and technology that produce all of this, you will not have this kind of explosion and then accidents. Science and technology. Destruction of life and properties. That's it. When you are using your gadget at home, now, of course, we bought their home appliances. And wrongly, or you use wet hand to plug something in the socket, the person will be electrocuted. And from there, gone. That's a whole other portion of the system. It's through the help of science and technology. These are the assets that science and technology has created. Four. Threat to national resources. Constant use of our national resources through science and technology is a threat. It's a threat to our natural resources because it will finish one day. Those people eating it, either they are drinking our resources like petrol, I don't even know. They don't know that one day it will finish. That is what is happening in Nigeria and in all the world. Let me tell you, this petroleum is not like before. Later, they will discover that there will be another resources that they are going to use instead of even some countries like half of China. They have already discovered another fuel that they can use for their vehicles. Let me tell you this. You don't know that this thing will finish one day. That is why Kabas are here, eating deeply into our resources. This land that is flowing of milk, that is flowing of milk and honey. See, God help us. Then, let's move to the science and technology in the future of Nigeria. But, in the future of Nigeria, what can we benefit through the science and technology in the future of Nigeria? One, food production. Our existing food production should be improved through science and technology for people to have abundant food to eat. In future, we must have abundant food to eat in future. Two, cheap housing materials. It will help to develop and provide cheap housing materials. That is through the science and technology. In that of future, you see some mighty buildings along Lagos Ibadan Expressway. Even go to Magodo, come to Lagos, go to Island. You see lots of ultra-modern buildings through the help of science and technology. Before, they used mud block, but now they are using rod, big iron to erect the building before they start building the modern things. Contractors know what I'm talking about. Then, three, improve health care. Some drugs, equipment, and medical experts will be provided through science and technology for our future, so that all these systems will not be eradicated. Some drugs, equipment. Okay, look at when they are talking about COVID-19. Imagine, Nigeria have to invite people from China to come to Nigeria. To come and do what? Assuming that we have those people that can do the discovery, the pirates. We need not to reckon with other people to come to Nigeria, bring all these China to come and show us the way. Look at my life, Kafka, what do they call it? They send drugs to Nigeria. Before you realize it, they will say it's trillions of naira. Which will import the drugs to Nigeria. Can you imagine that the leaders, they should try to improve on science and technology because of our future, because of the future of our students. There are a lot of factors hindering Nigeria technology. A lot of factors. One, lack of patriotic spirit among Nigeria. Those people that can serve Nigeria with their heart, that can serve Nigeria and provide what they need, that can use their mind to improve Nigeria. It's one of the factors hindering Nigeria technology. Two, indiscipline among Nigeria youth. Can you imagine that? When Baba said that Nigeria youth are lazy. Indiscipline among Nigeria youth. So I know that you are not lazy. Are you lazy? No, you are not. Indiscipline among Nigeria youth. Three, lack of dedication to work. Some are not dedicated. They are not even care at all. Four, Nigerians will demand for homemade goods instead of foreign-made goods. is abroad. This one is from China. This one is from Japan. That is all. Imagine that. This will put on our homemade goods, like clothes, bags, and many more. Five, high rate of corruption is another problem. You should try to avoid corruption. That one is talking to I and you, talking to the federal government. I'm not in a stage or in a place where I can embezzle money. Even if I'm here, I cannot embezzle money. I will work and sweat. I do sweat to get my money. These are the factors entering Nigeria technology. And there's some rules. You need to be trained for them to be able to handle, look at this computer of a thing. Some youth are not privileged to handle computer. They don't know what is meant by ICT. If you go to the rural area, they don't know it. But if they know it, they will join hands together with others and produce something before they force this country. The next time you are going to meet by next week, please take your book, make sure you read, and do all the necessary things and prepare for your CBT. God help us. Submit by next week. Thank you.